Hello students, welcome to the class on editorial decode, and in this class I will be dealing with a very important topic. Now this topic relates to right to children for free and compulsory education, second amendment bill. So in this class what we will be discussing is about the proposal of the government to bring about a change in this very important legislation, that is right to children for free and compulsory education. So some sort of amendment the government has proposed in this specific bill. Now what is this second amendment that the government has proposed? Now this relates to the detention policy. Now when it comes to the original amendment that the government had brought in the constitution, that amendment had brought in the concept of no detention. Now what is this no detention? Now no detention was a policy of education that the government had adopted, that no student would be detained in a class if he or she has not achieved a particular level of learning in a particular class. Despite someone not be learning the particular curriculum, some student not being able to gain what he was supposed to in a particular class in terms of the learning, even in that class, even in that case, the student will not be detained. He will be allowed to be promoted to the next class. Now suppose someone who is getting promoted to the sixth class did not know anything about the fourth, fifth class, then even in that case, in the original amendment that was introduced in the constitution, it was allowed that the student will not be detained. Now why this was kept? Now this was kept because the government, along with this no detention policy, had also come out with continuous and comprehensive evaluation, CCE. Now as per that evaluation, the student should be evaluated on a continuous basis. It was said that one single paper cannot assess the learning capacity of a student. So it is important that student should be assessed on a continuous basis. But this is something that requires a lot of rigorous evaluation process. This requires coming out with the standards and evaluating the student on a continuous basis. But this is something that is not easy, and this is something that has not yielded the results. Because when it comes to the Indian education system, we are actually short of teachers, and it is very difficult to provide them with this role of continuously and comprehensively evaluating the students. So this primarily resulted in the decline in the learning capacity of the students. So the students' learning capacity had declined. And why it has declined? It has declined not because the teachers were not teaching them. It had declined because there was no fear of the papers. There was no fear of the exam. And the students, they were not putting in the effort to learn the things of the curriculum. They were not actually imbibing the stuff. And this is the reason that now why we are actually amending this no detention policy. Now we are actually, by this bill, we are reintroducing the detention aspect in the Indian education system. So now again we are changing the denominators of the education policy. Again we are putting the focus on the aspect that it is the fear of the exam, it is the fear of the papers that will actually force, that will actually motivate the students to learn more. Because the students, they were not learning in a period when there was no fear, when there was no framework created to evaluate them on a yearly basis or on a half yearly basis. So this amendment relates to reintroduction of the detention policy. But now when it comes to the European countries and their education system, they generally don't detain the students. But in those countries, we have a very good evaluation process. the quality of the teachers, the pedagogical skills of the teachers, the way the curriculum is designed, it actually takes into consideration the need of the students. But with respect to India, the curriculum that is designed, it is designed in a bureaucratic manner. It is designed at the top by the bureaucrats, but without taking into consideration the actual requirement of the students. Requirement of the students and their social conditions. Requirement of the students and the geographical conditions in which they are studying. So all these things actually impact the learning capacity of the students. And that is the reason why we are bringing back this detention thing. This might help to increase in the learning capacity of the students, because the results of the no detention policy were actually bad. So this was all for the class. You can subscribe to this channel. Name of the channel is Brainy IAS. You can contact me at 845-94-000 if you have any kind of query with respect to this specific topic. So this was all for the day. Bye bye. Take care. Have a nice day.